Good evening. I am Rita Divedi. I am going to speak on cultural awareness that is helpful in business context and to avoid box pass. This is my third assignment, so I am going to start. It's not just professionals working overseas who need to learn cross-cultural business etiquette. Even if we work in our home country, our colleagues and suppliers could hail from other cultures. Our organization might decide to acquire or merge with an organization in a different country, and its customers too may located in dozens of countries worldwide. We have diversified culture. Our world's diversity is what makes it so fascinating. If we want to understand the reasons for this diversity, we should show respect for other people's cultures. And when it is done in a business context, it improves our working relationships and develops our own reputation. Considering cultural differences, we should consider the following questions when thinking about how a culture might differ from our own. What values does this culture embrace? How do those values compare with those of your culture? How do people make decisions, conduct relationships, and display emotion? How does this culture treat time and scheduling? What are the social rules and boundaries surrounding gender? How does this culture display and respect power? How do individuals relate to their employers? How do people in this culture communicate? How direct are they, what they say and mean? Below are some listed actions and items that could cause offense in a variety of cultures and countries. Regarding food, people abstain from eating and drinking certain foods for many religious and cultural reasons. Manners and expectations at the table can also differ. In Asian and Russian cultures, it's common not to talk during a meal because the food is the focus. Most conversation takes place after dinner. This is not the case in, for example, Japan, where colleagues often discuss work after hours and while socializing over a meal. Body language and gesture is also important. It can be challenging to know which gestures are taboos. A good rule of thumb is to avoid gestures until you are sure that they are acceptable. In India, Africa and the Middle East, people always use their right hand for greeting, touching and eating. They consider the left hand unclean, so you could never use it for anything publicly. Certain gestures considered acceptable in one country can be highly offensive in another. For example, a thumbs up gesture is seen as a sign of satisfaction in the West, but is highly offensive in some Middle Eastern countries. In many cultures, pointing is impolite, so it's usually best to avoid it entirely. If you must gesture toward something, use your entire hand. Clothing and color is also important. Some cultures pay careful attention to clothing. For example, it's important to be well dressed in Italy and United Arab Emirates, and sloppy or casual clothing is considered impolite. The color of your clothing could also cause offense. For example, never wear yellow in Malaysia. This color is reserved for royalty. In China, you will make a better impression by wearing red, which is considered lucky, than by wearing white, which is associated with death. Personal space is the distance that you keep between yourself and another person. It varies widely between cultures. In United States, many people prefer to keep 1 or 2 meters space between friends and family members, and up to 3 meters between strangers and business associates. These preferences are similar in the United Kingdom, Norway, Germany, and other European countries. Chinese people And people from other Asian cultures are also typically used to less personal space than Westerners. It's important to understand the personal space requirements of a different culture so that you are not perceived as rude by standing too far away or pushy by standing too close. Thank you so much.